Hi everybody, this is again a personal or a private client romance reading, and I would like to tell all of my viewers that personal romance readings, Lenormand readings and twin flame readings, particularly in twin flame services tab, you know, if you go to my website, are available. Please put a comment below the video or contact me on Facebook Messenger to get a reading or an audio session or any of the twin services which are available with me. Thank you so much. So again, this reading is for my private client, Nikki, and she had some questions, and I have done a Rider-Waite Celtic cross for her as well as her partner, and there were a few more questions which went beyond the Celtic cross. So for each question particularly, I have drawn cards from the Rider-Waite tarot deck, you know, particularly in regards to timing and advice that needs to be given here. So I will just read out the questions, Nikki, one by one, and then I will proceed on to the reading. This is a part of the Celtic cross that you're seeing right now as I speak. So the questions were, what things does he feel that I could improve on? So Nikki, that when I will read the Celtic cross and the other cards, the answers will come during that. So the first question was, what things does he feel that I could improve on? The second question is, what are his fears about us as a union? So guys, this is a twin flame couple that I'm reading for today, you know. They have taken previous prior readings. They have taken many readings, and this is a follow-up reading, you know. The third question is, what are his fears about us as individuals? The fourth question is he willing to open up to me about what things he is struggling with, soulfully, astrally, physically, emotionally? In what ways will we be brought closer in 3D? The sixth question is, when will I get to be with him in 3D? The seventh question is, can he show me or tell me something in 3D that he's interested? The eighth question is, what things should I focus on for my own growth in this, in his opinion? So I will go over the questions one by one towards the end when I've done the Celtic cross. Most of the answers you will get during the Celtic cross and the other cards that I've pulled out. For the questions which are not addressed during the Celtic cross in some way, I will go over those questions towards the end. So let me begin right now, Nikki. So this is a Celtic cross. This is a Celtic cross. This whole is a Celtic cross, which was done for you. So when I read for you here, Nikki, this Celtic cross was basically done for you, but there are a lot of overlappings which are in this Celtic cross also for Joey, you know, because of you being a twin flame couple. When Celtic crosses or Rider-Waite deck is used, it doesn't just mean one person, it actually means both of them in some way, because there are a lot of overlaps between twin flame couples, you know. They are not totally individualistic, you know, if you know what I mean. So there are a lot of overlaps. So as I will read the Celtic cross, a lot of it would also refer to him, and I will mention that as I read it. So first of all, I would like to tell you that the main card that I got for the person that I'm reading for, you know, which I again told that it's going to be a lot of overlap, is the Fool card. Now, I'm being, the channel messages that are coming through. Folks, I would like to tell you, and Nikki specifically, that when I read, I use cards from different decks, but most of my messages are generally channeled, which I get after I receive that particular card. So it's a channeled reading, it's not just a tool-based, a card-based reading, so it combines both of my skills. So when I get the Fool card, Nikki, I get this idea that somehow both you and Joey are very, at this point, are very innocent people, in a way that you both are not focusing on things that you need to do, you know. Like, you both are not mature enough soul at the soul level to be able to take the bull by the horns. You have a very innocent energy which shows that you are just beginning this journey, you know. This is what I'm being shown. You might have met before and you might have spent time before, but what I'm being shown is that you have a very very new energy right now. new energy in the meaning that it's not like you don't have experience or skill to handle this journey, you know. So that is what I'm being shown. And what passes you is the death card, the transformation card, you know. So this tells me that you had a very innocent energy, a very new energy, but then spiritual awakening started happening, you know, in both of you, possibly, you know. This is also, I'm being shown, that is why I mentioned the overlap in the beginning. So spiritual awakenings or transformations, small transformations or bigger transformations, you know, in the form of spiritual awakening started happening, you know, with both of you. Both of you were very new, very fragile, and, you know, not knowing what to do. But then suddenly this starts happening and you are taken unawares, you know, what is going on? What is this, you know? And that is when you realize that this is a part of the twin flame journey, and possibly going through those struggles with that person, you know, Nikki, that is when you realize the maximum that this is something different than a relationship, you know, this is something different than a relationship. That is possibly when the first idea of being a twin flame couple struck you, and that is how you got it confirmed and everything, you know. So this is what I'm being shown. And what has been behind you, Nikki? You have felt like, you know, you see this card, this is the Eight of Swords. You have felt like there's no coming out of the situation, you know. When these transformations or spiritual death was happening, you know, when you were feeling so tied down by this union, you know, and you did not know what this is all about, what is going on, you know, and later you realized that this is a part of the twin flame journey. At that time, you were feeling very trapped, you were feeling there is no way out, and you see this blindfolded lady. She, the swords don't even touch her, but she somehow feels that the swords are inside her, you know. You see all these bandages even on her body. She feels that the swords are inside her body, you know, and she's also blindfolded. She doesn't see a way out, you know. Even though there is a way out, she can easily walk on this path and get out. But she somehow lacked the resources or the knowledge. When the spiritual death was happening on the twin flame journey, you somehow lacked the knowledge and the resources were not available to you, and you did not understand what was going on. So you felt trapped and you felt as if you couldn't get out, you know. And then what has passed to be, you know, you have, like, you know, when you were in this situation, you somehow took some help and you used some resources and you came out victorious, you know. You came out, you kind of slay your fears, you know. You slay your fears and you slay your lack of knowledge regarding the twin flame journey. You got to read different articles and you got help from different people, and you finally came out of that and you realized what that is, you know. So you see the background, the dull gray background here, and you see the gray clouds have started like dispersing and you can see the blue sky again, you know. So this is what it means, that you somehow gained the knowledge and you gained the resources, the articles that you read and the knowledge that you gained. So you finally started realizing what this thing is all about, you know. So this has come to pass, you know, that has already happened. So what is above you now, and what is above you and what is going to happen in the future, you know. So what is above you, or what is going to transpire in the near future, and then what is going to transpire in the far future. Here you see a person, this is the Nine of Wands, you know. The Nine of Wands is a card which says that you have gone through a lot of growth period and you've done a lot of work, but you are still wary of new work coming in, you know. You have gone through a lot of transformation, your spiritual growth in this twin flame journey, but you're still very fearful. You see the face of this person and he's standing waiting for something more, you know. So you have gone through all these vans of spiritual growth, you know. This has happened, but you still have this van in your hand. You feel that anything new can come up at any time. You're so afraid now, you know, of all this happening with you. And then what is going to happen in the future? The Ace of Swords. Nikki, you're going to find a very bright idea, or you're going to increase your mental capacity, and soon you're going to find a new beginning, you know. You're going to find a very new beginning regarding a mental idea on this twin flame journey with your twin, like you are going to have a mental idea regarding your twin, how to handle him or how to handle the whole twin flame journey, and you're going to come out victorious. You see the crown? Like, it's going to happen all of a sudden. The hand is coming out of the clouds, you know. So you're going to have a certain big spiritual awakening, a very big epiphany is going to be given to you from the universe. See, this is coming out of the clouds, the hand, it's being going to be handed to you from the universe, you know. So a very big epiphany or a very big spiritual awakening is going to happen on this twin flame journey with your twin, and you are going to come out victorious, you know. So, Nikki, what have you been feeling, you know? What have you been feeling regarding this whole thing, you know? So this is what you have been feeling inside. You've been feeling heartbroken. You've been feeling very disappointed regarding Joey and the twin flame journey. See the again the dark gray background here. You have been feeling very heartbroken, very disappointed, and there are three swords in this heart, you know. You felt as if you've been denied what your heart desired, you know. You've been feeling this internally in your heart, you know. So, and what have you been feeling externally, you know? How has this heartbreak manifested externally? So how it has manifested externally is, you see these cups have fallen, you know, and there are only two standing cups left and something has spilled, and you see the black coat and the grey atmosphere. This is how you've been feeling. You've been feeling as everything is lost, you know, nothing is going to, like, there are still two cups remaining, but you're not even looking at it. You have your back against the two cups and you're just looking at what has been spilled. You're looking at what has gone wrong with Joey, and possibly you think at this time that nothing is going to come, nothing is going to get better, you know. This is how you feel externally. You feel that everything has been thrashed and slayed to the ground and nothing is going to improve, you know. But you see this stream, this river going, and there's a bridge, you know. So a bridge is coming soon for you, Nikki. You are going to have this bridge soon, which is a very positive thing, that the river is flowing, but there's a bridge here, and then there's a new, it's a new river coming out of the bridge, you know, kind of, you know, this is symbolic. So the river is the same, but there's a bridge, and like there's going to be a change. There's going to be this epiphany, this spiritual growth, and after the bridge, there's going to be a new river, you know. Your twin flame journey is going to be renewed after the spiritual awakening or the epiphany that you get. And what are your hopes and fears, or what does Joey possibly think, you know, are the hopes and fears in this situation, which addresses one of your questions again here. You are going to receive again from the universe, the hand is coming out of the universe, you're going to receive some financial opening, Nikki. And Joey also is concerned about finances a little, because I don't see stability. I don't see that much stability in the finances as both of you might want to start a 3D union, you know. So that is also going to happen. The universe is going to provide you with a financial opportunity in some way. And you see this garden, the gate is opening, and there's a very pretty view behind the gate, and you see this pathway. So you are going to be presented with this financial opportunity, a financial idea through the universe, you know, where you can work on, you know, some business project or something together, you know. And you're also going to have a spiritual epiphany, a spiritual awakening, and it's going to lead you to this bright garden, you know. You are going to enter this bright garden soon. Like you also had the bridge in another card, you know, a new life is going to begin. And even after entering this garden, a new life is going to begin with him. And the outcome card, the outcome.